In this video, we're going to look at the settings page of the S-Play Show Controller. On the left-hand side, you can see the navigation pane, allowing quick access to each function to reduce the need for scrolling. The first widget we've got is a device name. This will update on the S-Play LCD menu when you modify and save it. Scrolling down, we've got the output settings. The output settings are used to configure where you'll send the S-Play's 32 universes of internal data. You can select No Output, DMX, All ArtNet, or Streaming ACN. Here we'll select All ArtNet. When we're done, we'll press Update. If we open up ArtNet settings, we can see we've got the ability to toggle between unicast and multicast. So here we'll set unicast. We can set the refresh rate. And if we scroll down to each of the individual universes, you can see that, for example, I can set ArtNet 1 to universe 100. We can also set the unicast IP address here. By modifying an octet, let's say on ArtNet Universe 2 I'll set it to 20, we can see the rest of them update to make it simpler instead of having to manually configure every single box. If we scroll down, we can now press Update to save these settings. Carrying on, we can do the same thing for Streaming ACN to go between multicast and unicast. We've also got the option to set the refresh rate. Down the bottom, we can generate a different Streaming ACN ID or define the Streaming ACN priority. DMX settings is a lot more stripped back than this. Given you can define it at the output settings up the top, we simply use this box to define the frame rate. Next, we've got network settings. So you can set a static IP address, or you can receive an IP address using DHCP. By default, the S-Play is set to DHCP, but you can easily modify it on either the LCD menu or using this modal. Down the bottom, we've got the UDP and OSC input ports used for triggering. The S-Play's date and time settings allow you to use an NTP server to automatically update the time on the S-Play when it's connected to the internet. This time is stored in the S-Play's real-time clock, meaning you can power off the device, and when you turn it back on, it doesn't need to be connected to the internet to remember the time. You can select from a number of time zones, or define your own NTP server too. Next, we've got location settings. This is especially important if you're using the sunrise and sunset options on the S-Play. By knowing your exact location, the S-Play is able to predict when the sun will rise or set. The playback configuration options allow you to toggle on or off different settings that correspond to the playback of playlists on the S-Play. For more information about this, have a look at our introduction to playlists video. The final three options are fairly straightforward. We've got the ability to select storage, so either internal 8GB memory of the S-Play, or you can use an external SD card plugged into the front of the unit that can support up to 64GB. You can update the firmware by downloading a file from the ENTTEC website and uploading it through this UI. This will allow you to see the progress of the update and will automatically reboot your S-Play upon completion. Finally, we've got the option for factory reset. Before carrying out a factory reset, we recommend that you always back up your device. We hope you found this video useful. Drop any questions in the comments below or get in touch with our team at ENTTEC.com.